Come.
Have a goat here.
I remember when I couldn't level up. I was trying, but I couldn't level up.
Yo, what's up, big dog? I hope you guys are doing good. I don't know what day it is. I just know I'm in Africa right now. And I'm taking you guys today to the farm. So we go to the farm. In Benin is like 40 or 60 kilometers out of town. So we're gonna discover this today together. And yeah, I'm wearing a long sleeve because there's a lot of like fly and stuff back there. So you gotta protect your step and stuff. So, and there's gonna be a lot of like, I think I'm gonna use two languages for this vlog. I'm gonna go English and French at the same time. So let's go. You can do it,
never stop. What you guys saying? So we're going on that trip. I mean, it's not a trip. We're going to the farm. It's gonna be freaking wild. There's gonna be a lot of mosquitoes and a lot of flies. But yeah, we're gonna get the best out of it anyway. So, and I got my driver here, Boyty. I pay him, I'm not kidding, he's a big brother, but I do pay him. Yeah, so you guys stay tuned.
Tell them to them can't bury us. Tell them to them can't bury us. Cause the Lord make me stand up every time when I fall.
Traffic come back standing twice as tall.
I never thought that I could level up.
So you had to make a stop first and pick up same place. He has to work on the farm.
It was beating my bristle up and some BPS to ask my bezel up. Some of my guys might never see this.
Simply. So you had to pick up same place because he had to work on the farm and stuff.
Everyone,
to if you knew where I was coming from. And to anybody with they doubt me, I swear to make sure you never forget about me. If you think it's over, then you must be drowsy. I'm a motherfucking legend and I say it proudly.
At this point, we're off to the farm. We have to go through three cities: Calavi, Cotonou, Port Novo, and then go on the road to the farm. So it was about like technically 1 to 2 hours drive, but because of the traffic and the type of road we had here, it took up to like 2:30 to 3 hours.
You can do it, never stop.
I hope you guys are liking my city. So this area right there is called Cotonou, and that's like the economical capital of my country, Benin. Then after that, there's Port Novo, and that's the political capital of the country. All of this area right now is Port Novo. We are on Port Novo Road right now, and that's the farm.
Scary.
La mom Checo. La mom Checo. So right now we are at the farm. We made it like 5 to 10 minutes ago. It's crazy though because it has changed a lot like 5 years or 6 years ago, this was crazy. Like those trees, they grew. So what we do here is like we have like palm trees, and we produce palm. No, we did produce. Like we put in the soil, it grows, and then whenever it's time to harvest, we get it, and then we produce the oil out of those palm stuff. Crazy. So it's about I think 50 acres the property. So it starts on there, up there, it goes down there, it goes down because like all those palm trees is ours, like all of those palm trees. So it's kind of crazy. So she wanna show me a hole, she said. Let's check it. Boloa. She said there's a crazy hole here, I should check it out. Let's see what she calls crazy. Oh my god, yeah, that's huge. Can you move a shimbe? Like ganka. Okay, Doto. So this is gonna be like a water spot. In French we call it pre. I have no clue how you call it in English. But like most houses back in town, back in the city, has it. Like it's like you have your house, and in case of emergency, like when there's no water in town or whatever, you have a water safe somewhere. And technically you don't even need to fetch it because it comes in naturally. Like you just have to dig into the soil, and then boom, you dig until you reach the water, and it feeds in straight up. It's crazy though, that stuff has changed. So she's saying our farm started from there till there, and then it goes there, and then it goes down there. Yeah, I know it goes crazy because I remember like when I was coming here, like how do you call that?
Camera.
She's saying camera.
Yeah.
So I remember like back then when I was coming here, it was going down because there's like a waterfall. Like there's a waterfall down there. I really just don't want to go down there because look, all those stuff are crazy up there. So yeah, I really thank God we're not here for long, because most of the time when I was coming here with mom and dad, that's one of the reasons why I didn't like coming here. We spend the whole day. Like we come back in the morning and we leave in the afternoon. But today we're just here for that building, so we're like kind of making, it's like, let's say a storage room, and sometimes we can rest there too, so that whenever we are working or we are harvesting, we can stock them here. Because back then what we were doing is like whenever we are like we harvest and stuff, I think we were forced to produce right away or to take it to the spot where they produce right away. But now we want to have time to do all of those, and plus we live far from here, right? Because the farm is out of town kind of. So yeah, let's go.
Et on a sorti maintenant, même si on fait ça graduel, non, il est capable parce que tant un diga town.
Pas
3. Divisé en deux, ça oui.
Non. Tu sais pourquoi il dit pas 3?
Je
sais pas si c'est mon moral et tricé
tout le monde.
Et en plus de ça.
So we're going through the farm now, we're gonna check a little bit inside. You know what's funny? See the dress she's wearing right there? That she was mine 5 or 6 years ago. She's dripping my clothes right now, dripping. Oh, see, she got the sign and everything, she's doing gang shit. She's dripping hot. Bro, those vents are done, bro. Yo, it's crazy. Like, literally, that shit was so tiny. Now it's up. Like, all the way. Another good thing, though, the climate is different here. Like, it's hot out, right? But because I'm inside the farm and shit, that shit is super nice. Like, I'm not even feeling that it's hot no more. But as soon as I go out of this shit, I'm gonna be sweating like a pig. Un borde. Attention. There's a freaking river down there, I know that. Yo, there's a freaking huge river down there. She's like, I think it's 50 acres. I'm not sure, bro. I know it's huge. Like, Dallas is huge. And I didn't like coming here. I'm not even gonna lie. And today I came just because I knew it wasn't gonna be long. If mom was there, we're gonna stay here for the whole day. I swear I won't have came. She knows I'm having like, nah. And sorry if I'm not looking at the camera. That's because I have to pay attention to where I put my steps and shit. But yeah. Great. I hope you guys are enjoying the content so far. So, yo, that shit deep, deep. Damn, bro. That's like a workout. Bro, that fucker is working out. Yo, this is crazy, though, because I swear on God, that shit here, I'm pretty sure that shit was like water. I remember, like, I think it's how do you call it again? Like, it's getting dry and stuff. Because from up there, like, you could hear the water at that time. But right now, it's gone. There's no water no more. So those are the nuts from the... Those are the nuts from the palm tree. So you can use that to make like red oil. You can even use it to cook like a lot of stuff. You can make soap with that shit. You can make many types of oil. You can also make you can make alcohol with that too. Like with the branches, you can make alcohol. So crazy. Un bordé.
Voici la limite naturelle. Stand. So, the limit. This is the tree they use for the limit here in the village.
Okay.
Yeah, so I remember these limits. So this is the limit. So go back up on the top, on the slope there.
I'm still alive, guys. I hope you guys enjoy the content. I really, really hope. Because it's not easy. Yeah. Oh yeah. Un bordé. So un bordé. That's, I have to give credit to my brother. His name is Faisal Garba. He's the one who brought it back. Like, I think he has to bring to get ownership of that one. Un bordé. Yeah, I'm sweating, I know, it's crazy. I really can't wait to go home. And I'm not even going home because I have a studio session. So I have to go home, get ready, go to the studio session, eat some food and in between, and after that go back to the studio, go to a restaurant, eat with some friend, because we're linking up.
It's
like a small village right next to the farm. So they have like those old type of houses here. And I would say those ones are the new ones because the building material is different, you know. But yeah, see, it's different here, but that's the old type. But from what I know is that the old ones are better than the new one because the old ones are super cold. The temperature is good inside. But since those ones are completely closed and there's no electricity in it, it's warmer in there. So yeah, you're discovering my farm and the village right next to the farm. Tai! There's a goat here. So this is a pineapple field. Literally, it takes like 1 year to get pineapples. I didn't even know that. Even more than that, sometimes 1.5, like crazy. Oh, what's up? So it's done. I mean, we're living. I mean, I'm living. I don't know about them. They're still talking. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I showed you today the farm. I showed you what a small village looks like. That bigger village than those ones. And the people actually live here. And they grow here. Like, everything is fine. They have a normal life because they go to school.
eat properly. I showed you the guy who was doing like pineapple stuff. So yeah, thank you guys for watching this vlog. And I'm so sorry I didn't post earlier because I could have made way more vlogs. It's just too much work. I have to shoot first, then edit, and make sure you have great content. I'm gonna try to keep up because I have two YouTube channels. I have my personal one and my beat making one, so it's kind of hard. Anyway, thank you guys. Subscribe, like, share, and see you on the next one.